Hello, it's Erin from the Joy in Pen and Paper. I just received another one of my Christmas gifts that I partially bought for myself. So one of the kind of big changes coming up is, and I think I mentioned this in one of my planning videos, a new assistant director was hired at work who is going to take half my job. Yay! And he started the week before winter break. And at the same time, our boss was out sick for the week. So I took on a bit more responsibility with assisting with onboarding, making sure I gave him a lot of information. I prepared his schedule and a number of other helpful documents, specifically a document with all of the links to all the things within the Google Workspace that he would benefit from, and walked through any of the issues that came up during the week with him, and likely will continue doing that for the next couple of weeks before I really start to hand over the reins. But at the end of that week, he gave me a very lovely card thanking me for all of my help and included in there a gift card to Amazon. As well, one of my staff members gifted me with a Visa gift card, and so I was able to put those together and get this gift for myself. So this is a Pilot Decimo. I have really wanted a Pilot Decimo for, goodness, I will say a number of years now. But with having the Vanishing Point, I couldn't really justify getting the Decimo just because it was so similar. But as I've kind of gone through the last couple of years and gotten some other pens that were cheaper or lower price point, I should say, great quality but lower price point, as well as had the support of my husband and my family to get some other pens that I really liked. I did think that having a gift card to put towards this gave me an opportunity to purchase this pen. Is a nice case. So it's kind of a hard plastic case. It has the little pamphlets and a cartridge. And then on this little velvet bed is Decimo. Now, the other thing with getting this on Amazon, which, not my preferred location for pen purchases, there wasn't as many choices. And so I went back and forth with the color quite a bit. I knew I really loved this champagne color, pink, but it's called champagne. I also really liked the lilac or lavender colored one. And I found one that had a picture that looked like this color, but the description was, I think it was called White Pearl, that was cheaper, lower in price. And so I originally purchased that. And while I was waiting for it to ship, I just kept going back to the pictures and I kept looking at the Amazon kind of stock photo, and it did appear to be this color. And then I was scrolling through the other pictures and then reading the reviews and looking at them, and just the pictures from customers, the pen was white. And I have a white with black trim Vanishing Point. So I ended up canceling that order and then going back and getting this, even though it was a little bit more money. I think the difference was maybe $10. And again, because it's Amazon, not as many choices. So it was really difficult to find an extra fine, and the extra fine on Amazon seemed to be marked up quite a bit in price. So then, rationally, I thought, well, gosh, I have an extra fine. I actually have two extra fine. And I just purchased the medium nib part this summer, and I'm using the medium in a Moon Man body. And so, fine. Seems just fine. Now I have the three sizes, and so I can, based on the type of ink I'm going to use, use the right ink to get the best experience. Now, opening it up, I'm gonna put it in the box. So we have this unit right here. It is a fine, and it has this kind of a cartridge that's inside. Now, I had purchased, let me put that down too. A multi-pack of the Pilot Con 40. Because I think, yeah, three pack. Because it's a this I'm intending to use one of them for the Pilot Kokuno. But I think this will fit in here. So I already had this piece for it. Yeah, I think that is a fit. So there it is. And I'm just looking closely at the markings. I think I made a point to do my research. This should be, yes, 18 karat. So this is an 18. Oh, I don't know. Right on that left side, this is an 18 karat nib, 18 karat gold nib. All right, now ink. I was planning on Vinta Armada, but now I want to look back through and confirm that's actually what I want to do for this pen. Kind of diamined out. So this is the Vinta Armada, and it's this kind of on the medium to darker side, grayish blue with some pink shading. It's likely where I'm going to end up. I'm using the brown gray in another pen this month. I'm nervous to put a shimmer ink in right away. Maybe mulberry. I'm gonna stick with what I had previously picked out. Sorry for my indecision. And There we go. Just pushing it up a little bit just because it's the first time that I'm inking. I think I see. And let's remove this. Oh, it says decimo right there. Yeah, I am very happy that I went back and got this champagne color. I would have regretted not having this color. Okay, I'm going to take out my Tomoe River Everyday book. And we can use, actually let's just do this. You know, I was thinking for a moment that this didn't feel a whole lot lighter than the regular Vanishing Point, but as I got it ready to write, that's where I feel the difference. So it is lighter. And if I were smart, I would have brought up my Vanishing Points for comparison. Yeah, another time. Oh, yep, I like that. All right, so this is a Pilot Decimo Vanishing Point in champagne with a fine nib, and it's inked up with Vinta Armada. And you can get the tines to open up a little bit to get some flexing. Really not a whole lot in reverse. That color is beautiful. You can just see the variations. I wish the camera picked it up a little bit better. That is a beautiful pen. And it's got that nice click. Which makes this such a great on-the-go pen. It's, one of my favorite things is sitting in a meeting or being at work and using a vanishing point. And it's I know that the writing experience is very different than anyone else who's taking notes at the meeting. So beautiful. So that is my new baby. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And for those of you that have just subscribed to my channel, thank you so much. My goal was to get to 250 subscribers by the end of the year. I did that. I surpassed that. So I appreciate you so much. If you're not currently subscribed, I hope this was enjoyable and perhaps you'll consider subscribing, or in the future I'll post something else that interests you, which will motivate you or prompt you to subscribe. So thank you. Happy 2023 again. We're still in the new year, and I look forward to my next and I think final Christmas package, which is some inks that I will be swatching. So thanks. Bye.